Hello and welcome back to another episode of Dirty Leeds, the David Batty story. I'm your host, Captain Berryman FM, and I welcome you to this promotion challenge where we're going to take Leeds United from the Championship back to the Premier League, back to the big time. One season, one legend, one goal. How have we been getting on since we were last together? Well, we were in October, no, now into November. We haven't played many games, so we're going to get through two matches today. I'm going to show you really quickly. Last time we played was against Manchester City in the Carabao Cup, where we lost 1-0. We've only played one game since then against Wigan Athletic, where we drew 0-0 away at the DW Stadium. And it was not the best performance from us. We were a bit of an hangover, shall we say, from the Carabao Cup. But today, I'm going to be bringing you two games. I was going to come back to you for Bristol City versus Reading, but I completely missed West Brom. So West Brom are a bigger team, so we're going to come back for that. It's West Brom away from home. They are struggling at the minute in 22nd. And then Bristol City, who are 5th, and we've got them back at Elland Road. Nothing's really changed with the league standings. Obviously, we've only played that one game. And that's it. Nothing else to bring you because it's been such a quick turnaround straight on to the games. And here we go. We're playing at 3 o'clock today. Normally we are the 5:30 kickoff team, but not this time around. I'm expecting a win today. West Brom are struggling at the bottom end of the table. And I feel like we're back to our full strength team. We're going to go with Casillas. We've got Berardi, Janssen, Cooper and Douglas at left back. We've got Phillips and Klitsch in the middle. With Hernandez on the right hand side. Sawyers, Alioski and Kemar Roofe up top. On the bench, we've got Peacock Farrell, Kabul, Forshaw, Rossi, Aylin, Dallas and Patrick Bamford. Patrick Bamford. It must have been a poor start to the season because that is a strong, strong West Brom team. Dwight Gayle, Matty Phillips, Jay Rodriguez, just to name a few players. This is going to be a tough, tough game. But I am going to come in passionate like I always say. We are the favourites here. Go and give the fans something to cheer about. Let's do it for the fans, I always say. And then come in nice and calmly and say you can make the difference. They get the game underway. We are at the Hawthorns. It is a massive, massive match. We struggled against the teams down the bottom end of the table, to be fair. But we've got the first highlight, and Hernandez puts it in there. Dawson does edit away. It's going to fall for Janssen from the clearance. Here comes Kemar Roofe. He's going to go himself. He crosses it in, and there's Alioski at the back post. And the entertainers, Leeds United, are in front. And it is first blood to us. What a fantastic ball that is from Kemar Roofe. I thought he was actually going to go for the shot. Janssen, plenty of cool, calm manner there. Puts the ball into the box. And there's Alioski at the back post. Back from his little time off. He did not play against Wigan because he needed a bit of a rest. And now he's got back onto the score sheet. 1-0 to Leeds. And saying that, we'll go straight back onto the highlight. There's Klitsch and he hits the side netting. First highlight after 24 minutes for West Brom. And here comes Johansson to Jay Rodriguez. He's coming forward. He goes for the pass. There's Dwight Gayle. It's a massive save from Casillas. And he does save us right there. Here's Kelvin Phillips with a free kick. Smashes the corner. It's between the post and the bar. The beans on toast. And it comes away. Oh, and it stays 1-0 to Leeds. We're straight back into another highlight though. Sawyers to Berardi to Klitsch. It's a massive tackle. Well, it's actually a foul from Jake Livermore. And it's a penalty. And Mateus Klitsch has the opportunity to put the ball into the back of the net. Can he do so? He does. It kind of trickles past Sam Johnston. And Leeds are absolutely flying. 61% possession today. 11 shots to West Brom's 2. And we've only played 33 minutes. And it is 2-0 already. And this could be an absolute rout. Only a couple of minutes before the break, West Brom come back into this. And they have. And they don't deserve it. I'm going to just say that. They do not deserve that. Poor defending from us. Straight from a set piece. I mean, they are known for their set piece taking. Header back in by Craig Dawson. And there's Jake Livermore to fire it home. And that is against the run of play. And we go into the break. Disappointing end to a fantastic, nearly perfect half of football from us. The assistants has got there and prove a point today. Absolutely. Do not let this slip. Do not let this lead go to waste. We are miles ahead of this team. Saying that, here come West Brom. Helgazi with the header and he heads it over the bar. I'm hoping that goal before the break is not giving these guys a bit of a boost here. And it looks like it has. They've come flying out the tracks after the break. Berardi does really well there, but he only heads it out to Higazi. Here comes Jay Rodriguez. Tries to find Matty Phillips. He finds Matty Phillips. He'll put it into the box. And there's Dwight Gayle. And it's 2-2 within a blink of an eye. Within 10 minutes of the break. They've scored two goals. Ah, oh, for crying out loud, Leeds. We were absolutely steamrolling. And Dwight Gale with the easiest of tap-ins. It's West Brom 2, Leeds United 2. There's a highlight straight away, and we are struggling in this second half. We're going to have to make a change in a minute because they are massively on top. And here comes Matty Phillips to make it free, and it's they've turned it around. And Leeds, are doing a classic Leeds and getting beat after going 2-0 up. Samfield, Jay Rodriguez with a ball and a half. And there is Matty Phillips, who brings it down and fires it past Kiko. And they've completely turned this game on its head. It's West Brom 3, Leeds United 2. And we are going to need to make some changes. We're going to get Stuart Dallas onto the pitch and get Ramon Sawyers off, who hasn't been playing particularly very well recently. Last couple of games, he's been taken off at this stage with like a 6.3 and a 6.4. We're going to put Stuart Dallas on this right-hand side. He played so well against Nottingham Forest in the last game. Barry Douglas on a 6.4 as well, but we ain't got really a left-back to put anyone. Calvin Phillips, I am actually going to get him off. And we're going to get Adam Forshaw on because I just feel like we need a little bit more engine room in the middle. And Berardi is actually having an absolute stinker out there on a 6.0. We're going to get Luke Ayling on. It is a triple substitution from Leeds United. And I'm going to say to the lads, get creative out there. Let's get back into this game. I'm demanding a point now. We cannot lose this match. And it's all West Brom. We haven't had a single highlight in the second half. And here they come against Sam Field now to Johansson. Back to Field. I mean, they've hardly won a game this season. Gibbs puts it into the box, headed away from Douglas. It comes to Phillips. It's all over. It's 4-2. What an absolute, unbelievable shit show from Leeds United in the second half. We were winning two goals to one at the break, and we've now gone down by 3 goals in the second half to a team that were 22nd in the league. Our defence has had an absolute shocker today. It's over and out. We lose. I can't see us getting back into this game. Ask for a bit more, demand more from the players. And they're coming again. They could absolutely batter us here. There's a penalty. Oh my days. We're absolutely crumbled. We've absolutely crumbled. Matty Phillips, hat trick, 5-2 to West Brom. This is an alarm bell, I'm not going to lie. David Batty has not been beaten like this or has not really lost a game like this. In this manner, since taking over as Leeds United boss, and wow, there's got to be some changes. Headed away, here comes Glitch now, goes for the strike, hits the bar, and what a shocker, eh? What an absolute shocker. Hernandez back to Ayling, puts the ball into the box, it comes out to Glitch, can he get a shot away? He tries to. He just blocks it against the man. Here comes Matty Phillips. Phillips running at his light. Lionel Messi gives it to Dwight Gale to make it 6. It's a big save. And he stops this from becoming even more embarrassing. And I think that will be that. And it is. And we've taken an absolute thrashing at the hands of West Bromwich Albion. Absolutely am I disappointed with that result. We need to rectify this at home against Bristol City in the next game. Oh, what an absolute shocker. Matty Phillips helps West Brom clear the drop. We've lost to so many teams down the bottom end of the table. It's just criminal. Forget about it. Move on to the next game. I'll see you there in 2 ticks. Right, game day is upon us. We need to bounce back from that absolute thrashing we've just got from West Bromwich Albion. We are still 4 points clear at the top of the table ahead of Aston Villa. So we need to get a result today because they're playing Birmingham and Birmingham are not doing very well. And if they get the win, they're only going to be 1 point behind us. This is going to be the starting lineup for today's game. It's Kiko, Casilla in goal with Ayling, Jansen, Cooper and Douglas. Ayling backing for Berardi after he had that shocker. Phillips and Glitch in the middle with Dallas on this right-hand side. Hernandez, Alioski and Ruth. Hernandez coming behind the striker. Not because Sawyer has been dropped, because he's injured. Jack Clark is on the bench. He's getting back to full fitness and will feature some point today. They have got pretty much their full strength team out, so it's going to need a big performance from us to get a result today. Things are starting to get very interesting. Go out there and give the fans a performance they are expecting, and then come on board very nice and calmly. Nice, good cop, bad cop, and say you have got what it takes. Take it out of your pockets, lads. Put it onto the pitch, and let's get the 3 points. They get the game underway. Come on, Leeds. And what a terrible game of football it's been so far. 25 minutes gone and not a single dangerous highlight to report on. And it looks like we're going to go into the break here. And they've had the best of the game, but there hasn't been a single highlight so far. I'm going to say to the lads that their performance is disappointing. Let's go out there and get back to what we were doing at the start of the season, boys, because this is not good enough at all. We are short of confidence, it looks like, especially Kemar Roofe up front. Still no highlights, 60 minutes on the clock, and oh, wait a minute. Pause the game, ladies and gentlemen. There is a highlight, and I think it does fall to Leeds United. It does. Luke Haley's headed away by Patterson. Here comes Phillips, puts the ball into the box. He's headed away by Hunt. Falls to Barry Douglas. Douglas, we just need to get a scrappy 1-0 win and confidence will come back. Alioski now. He is crowded out a little bit, but he does find the pass to Klitsch. Klitsch to Douglas, who loses it to Wyman. And here comes Watkins, but it's a big tackle from Calvin Phillips. Janssen picks it up to Cooper. We're going out to his left-hand side. And here we go down the middle. It's Pablo Hernandez, the magic man. Gives the ball to Stuart Dallas. Puts the ball into the box. And there's Kemar Roofe. He's onside. Leeds are in front. I was just about to say Leeds win. And I'm getting ahead of myself just there. It's a packed out Ellen Road, as you can see from the stands around us. It's a lovely pass from Pablo Hernandez. There's Stuart Dallas, who was just about to take off. And there's Kemar Roofe, who I was just about to take off as well, to get the goal, the assist, and the goal scored at 18 this season. Fantastic stuff. This is currently putting us 7 points ahead of Aston Villa. They've got to play a little bit later on today, so hopefully it puts the pressure on them. Stuart Dallas to Janssen. We need a second goal to just calm the nerves. Phillips, we've been the better team in the second half. Aileen puts the ball over the top. Alioski's going for it. I'm looking for a penalty. Nothing there. Douglas puts the ball into the box. Stuart Dallas coming in at that post to get his third of the season. And the Northern Ireland international has probably put this game to bed. It's 2-0 to Leeds, and we have played a lot better in the second half. I say we've played a lot better. We've had two highlights, and both of them have gone in. But I don't care how it happens, as long as we get the 3 points. And Stuart Dallas has just done that. What a ball from Barry Douglas that was. Fantastic stuff. Literally just above 10 minutes. Oh, I was just about to say, just more than 10 minutes on the clock to go. And our goalkeeper has palmed it into his own net. Josh Brownhill has got one back for Bristol City. It's not the best goalkeeping, I'm not going to lie. I was just about, we're on attacking, that's the problem. And I was just about to come off attacking, and Bristol City are coming forward. Here comes Patterson, big tackle from Leeds. And here come Kemar Roofe now on the counter-attack. He takes his man, he beats his man. He's running forward with it, it's a big tackle. We do get the ball back though, it's Klitsch with the strike. It's a big save from Frank Fielding. I am going to knock this down to balanced. We are going a bit more cautious though now. We're not going to just be going gun-ho. We need to keep hold of this lead. It's a massive lead. 10 minutes to go. Are we looking a little bit tired? I can't even get off. There's a highlight straight away from the goal kick. And can Leeds put this game to bed? Callis wins the header. Gives it to Pack. Back to Callis. And Bristol City are no team to slouch about. They are up there in the playoffs. Big header from Janssen. Can Klitsch put it through for Dallas? He goes for the header. It comes Kemar Roofe. Smashes it against the post. And that could be a turning point in this game. We are going to just make one substitution though. We are going to get Klitsch off in the middle, and we're going to get Adam Forshaw on, that experience. A bit more legs in the middle as well. And we're going to get Alioski off, and we're going to get Jack Clark on to his left-hand side. Get him as an inside forward on attack and see what we can do from there. And here come Bristol City with only 4 minutes left on the clock. Here comes Patterson. Here comes to Josh Brownhill. Who fires it into the back of the net. From 25 yards out, we're going back attacking. And we've thrown away another 2-goal lead here. This is classic Leeds. Classic Leeds. The world is imploding around us. Oh my God, we've got a chance. Douglas, can we get the ball into the box? Cooper wins the header. It comes to Jack Clark, the 17-year-old. Go for the strong. Oh, I thought that was in. Oh, this is a disaster. What a shocker, and it looks like that's going to be that. We're not going to get another highlight here. After going 2-0 up, we're only 5 points clear. Villa win later today against Birmingham. They will be only 2 points behind us. Brown, I mean, this game is not over yet. Here comes Patterson, puts the ball into the box as he gets a corner. No, the referee does blow. That's controversial as well. And it ends 2-2. We can't stop conceding goals at the minute, and it is a real, real concern. There is confirmation. Leeds have thrown away another 2-goal lead. And look at our recent form. It's not the best. A defeat to Ipswich, followed up by the 7-1 thrashing of Notts Forest that I brought you in the last episode. But since then, a draw, a defeat, and a draw. 2 points out of possible 9. It's not title-winning form, is that? And we're not even hit December just yet. So We need to get a win against Reading and against Sheffield United. I'm going to come back for the next game, though, against Aston Villa, which is on the 22nd of December. And then we're going to bring you the game against Blackburn as well, which is on Boxing Day. Two crunch games bring you in the next episode. But I will be back after I've played one, two, three, four games. And these four games are absolutely massive. By the time I come back, I might not even be top of the table. Pressure's on. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this episode as much as I have. If you have, give it a like, give it a thumbs up, and leave comments in the section below. Let me know if you're enjoying the episodes. Let me know what you think of the series so far. If you do like these kind of videos, do go to my YouTube page and subscribe at Captain Birdieman FM. You can see the stuff is just next to me here. Also, if you're on Twitter, go and follow me at Captain Birdieman FM as well. You know the drill, ladies and gentlemen. I will be back in a couple of days' time with another installment of Dirty Leeds, the David Batty story. Bye-bye.